Hi, in this tutorial we will talk about the VrayCryptomatte render element. As you know, in the Vray frame buffer, after you render the image, you can perform some post-production operations. You can add things like curves, saturation, exposure, things like that. The same way like when you open the image in a photo editing program like Photoshop. So the thing is that sometimes you want to perform these operation on a certain object after you render, and CryptoMate will help you to do this. Now we will try the CryptoMate on simple objects, and after that we will try it on an actual scene. On a side note, since V-Ray 0.2 it works in the progressive mode in addition to the bucket mode. So go to render elements, click add, and choose the VrayCryptomatte. Here in the ID type, you can choose the criteria based on what you can pick objects in the Vray frame buffer. CryptoMatte works like a mask tool. So by default, it's the node name. That means you can choose by objects. You can choose individual objects in the Vray frame buffer. I will give it a significant name here. Right underscore, let's say object named. You will see why, because we can add multiple VrayCryptomatte here, and each one will work based on different criteria. So now, after adding this, make sure the Vray frame buffer is checked, and now let's render the image. I will choose one of the post-production tools, let's say the hue saturation. So right click here, new layer, CryptoMatte mask. You can see here the name that we've chosen, VrayCryptomatte object names. And now click this button here, pick, and let's say I wanna work on this sphere. You can see here the name of the objects under the mouse, so I will pick this one. You can see the name here, and I will choose this one. So now go back to properties, and let's change the saturation. You can see here those two. You can change the hue. And go back to the CryptoMatte and pick another object. Let's say this one. And it's immediately affected by the value of the saturation. Go back here. Let's say you want to remove one of these. Click this button here, and let's say I want to remove this sphere here. Now, I can add another hue saturation. Let's say, okay, let's try another tool here, color balance. Right click, new layer, CryptoMatte mask. Pick, I will pick this pyramid, go to properties, and let's change the color. Okay, let's change the okay, now I will remove all of these and start all over. I will add another CryptoMate this one I will call it material name. Now I want to choose by the node material name. Let's render. I will add hue saturation again. Right click, new layer, CryptoMate mask. Here you can see that in the drop down, now I have two CryptoMate. And this is why I gave them significant names, so I can know what I want. I want to use the CryptoMate that will help me choose by material. So click pick. Now, when you hover the mouse, you can see here the name of the material. So I will click, you can see pink material. If I go to the material editor, it is this material. So now go back to properties, and when you play with the saturation, all objects that are using this material will be affected. So basically these three. I can add a hue saturation, another one. Right click, new layer, CryptoMate mask, and this one, instead of object name, I can choose, this one, I will choose the object names. So in this case here, I want to pick individual objects, let's say the text, and this teapot, go to properties. So as you can see, I have two hue saturation, each one with a different CryptoMate render element. Each CryptoMate has different criteria of choosing objects in the frame buffer. Again, to make the tutorial simpler to understand, I will delete those and start all over. I will add a third CryptoMate. I will call it by layer, and I will choose the criteria, which is the layer name. Here I created a layer called boxes and teapots. It contains those two boxes and those two teapots. So render. I will add, let's say, now I will try it with the curves or exposure. Right click, add layer, crypto mask, and I will choose the bilayer one. Pick, here you can see the name of the layer. The other one is zero, so because the others are on the layer zero, but this one is on the boxes and teapots, so I will click and you can see the name of the layer here. Go to properties and you can play with the exposure, contrast, again delete. Let's add another crypto mat. This one I will call it OBJ properties, and I will choose the criteria now, the node user property. Now for this one I will select this object and this object and this object and this object and this one, those five objects. I right click, object properties, user defined. I will choose a custom name, whatever. Let's say objects and equal one. I will give all of these five the value of one. I will copy this value here, press OK. Now when you choose the node user property, you will have this option here. I will paste the property that I've chosen for these five objects, which is objects, and now click render. What will happen now is when I hover the mouse over one of the objects that I've chosen, that I've selected, it will check the properties and see if there is something here in the user defined, and it will see the name objects that I've added here, and it will see the value of this object variable, which is one, and it will check if there is another object in the scene with the same variable name and with the same value. So now I will choose hue saturation again, new layer, CryptoMate mask. Okay, I will choose this one, object properties. Pick. You can see here the value 1, and this one the value 1. Okay, I will pick this one. See, you see here the value 1 that I've chosen for the variable objects. Now when I play with the saturation, you can see that those five objects are affected, because these five objects, they have the objects variable, and this variable in those five is the same. It has the same value, which is 1. Of course, you can choose different objects and use different, use the same name here, objects, but give it different value. Okay, here I have this scene. I will go to render element. and add a cryptomate I will leave the default node name and I will do a quick render. Okay, the rendering is finished. I already have an exposure here. I will add another post-production element here. I will choose, let's say, color balance. Right click, new layer, CryptoMate. And I will choose this chair here. Actually, it's only the seat because this is a group of objects, and I picked this element in the group. I will choose this chair also. You can see it changed. So basically that's it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. If you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.